all the rush of the holiday season, it's hard to get everything done on this to-do list. All the shopping, and we've got the wrapping, and then the parties, too.
Well, yeah, you gotta have the parties. Absolutely. So the Red Cross knows that, and they're offering some extra incentive for giving blood, and also reminding us why it's so important.
Yeah, welcome back, Katie Marshall.
Thank you so much for having me. It's fantastic, and it's a busy time of year for the Red Cross, for sure, but we want to make sure that we're reaching out to donors and we're meeting the need for patients. All times of year.
And that's what we want to talk about right now, because there's a big need for blood and platelets right now, right? And why is this a time when you really need those donors?
Absolutely, because we tend to see that decline. All those things you talked about, we're so busy with 1,000 things on our plates, whatever it may be. Schools are out of session, and they're 20% of what we bring in as the Red Cross. So with the schools out of session, we're losing touch with our college donors, our high school donors, and it's flu season as well. So if you're not feeling well, we ask that you take care of yourself first before you donate. So many different factors that are keeping donors possibly away, and we want to make sure that we continue to meet the need that we have.
Yeah.
Kind of that thing you can take for granted, that you think if somebody has to have, you know, they have some sort of medical issue or an accident, and God forbid they need blood, you just assume it's going to be there. But you really count on people and schools, as you said.
Absolutely. We constantly need to replenish the blood supply. Blood only lasts 42 days, and there's constantly a need. I mean, I just talked to a family yesterday that moved into the hospital this week. Their four-year-old is battling cancer right now, and they're going to be in the hospital on Christmas Day, on New Year's Day, and she's going to require blood and platelets. So it's important that we have those there available. I mean, can you imagine? The worst thing would be on those days to be waiting for it, to not have them available. So we want to make sure that we're taking care of these kids, these patients, everybody who might possibly need blood on these days.
They're going through a difficult time. It's hard enough. You don't want to have them deal with that as well.
But
you have both high-tech and old-school ways to reach out to donors right now. And I've got this card right here. Explain how this works.
That's the old-school one right
there.
Yes, that is a postcard. I don't know if you remember. I don't even know how much postcards say.
Google that, kids.
Postcards.
But don't you love to get real mail right now?
Yes.
And when you're giving something like blood, it's so fun to be able to share with your family and friends and say, hey, I did this, and I would love if you would give this gift as well. So that's a great way that you can do that.
Yeah.
Pick up a postcard when you get to one of our blood drives and just send it out to a friend or a family member. Encourage them to do the same.
Yeah.
Some of the high-tech ways that you can do it is you can do it through our Red Cross Blood Donor app. That just launched in September. It's been very successful, and there are very fun ways that you can build a team and you can encourage each other. You can get different kinds of rewards and discounts on things through that app. And then we just launched what we're calling the Sleeves Up campaign. I'm so excited about this. This is a way that you can launch your own campaign. We're calling it a virtual blood drive. So say I was looking up, there was a 9-year-old girl. Her birthday's coming up next week. She can't give blood. She's too young. But she wanted 9 people to give blood for her 9th birthday. So she's sending out emails to friends and family, and she's holding a virtual blood drive. And that way, it's not something you could just do with your friends and family right there, but you can do it long distance and encourage people all around the country.
How do you do that? Do you have to go to the website, or do you do it on the app?
No, you can do that on the website. Just look for the Sleeves Up campaign, and you can create one for, say it's your birthday. Maybe you want to do it in honor of somebody who was in an accident or is battling cancer or who has a blood disease, or you want to do it in memory of somebody, or it's an anniversary coming up. For all of these different reasons, you can pick, and then it's a very user-friendly website.
You know, it's wonderful too to have something if you're financially stressed. This is still a great way to contribute and help others this time of year.
Absolutely. We're looking for very real ways that how can we impact lives? How can we really make a difference? And this is incredibly profound. Every single blood donation has the potential to save 3 lives. And we're talking about how crazy busy the season is. It's crunch time for so many people. I mean, what a way to really slow down for maybe just an hour. It just takes an hour of your time to donate blood, the whole process of it. And to say that you've really made an impact on somebody else, I think that's really an incredible way to make a difference during the season.
Yeah. Any stories you want to share real quick before we let you go? And then we want to talk about this the big blood drive that's coming up next week.
Yes, absolutely. We have a couple of little girls that we are featuring right now over the season. This family's been very willing to share. Both of their families have been willing to share their stories. I mentioned Kenzie's family. They're the ones that just moved into the hospital. Mm-hmm. This is Lolo, actually. Lolo
that's
Hacker.
I know Lauren Hacker.
Do you know Lauren Hacker?
Yes.
A fantastic family. Lauren is now 12 years old. She was diagnosed with leukemia on 12-12-12. She spent Christmas in the hospital in 2012. She is doing very well now, but she did receive blood and platelets, quite a few of them, while she was at Children's Hospital for about 6 months. So she's just a very true living example of the fact that blood donors helped save her life, made a really profound impact on her life.
Absolutely. And you've got this, you're the biggest blood drive coming up, right?
Yeah, I want to point out Kenzie, too. This is Kenzie and her little brother, Emmett. And Kenzie is currently battling neuroblastoma. She's from Lincoln. She will be in the hospital through the holidays, and she is receiving treatment right now. Just a beautiful little girl. She turned 4 years old this week. And her brother also, he's just 5 months old. He received blood products when he was just 4 days old. He had to have surgery for a hernia. So that family, very, very much so. And these beads that you're seeing right there, there's red beads on there. Every procedure that she goes through, she receives a bead for her beads of courage. And all the red ones, which there were several, are blood transfusions.
Yeah, we have to wrap this up, but I want to talk about this big blood drive. It's coming up next week. What is it?
Yes, this is our holiday blood drive. It is in Omaha, Council Bluffs, and Lincoln on Monday. It's exactly 4 months after the Let It Bleed drive that we talked about. That was August 22nd, and it was at the same two locations in Omaha and Council Bluffs from 6 a.m. until 6 p.m. And these shirts that I've had on my lap, every presenting donor will receive one of these shirts. And it's not just at the holiday blood drive coming up on Monday. It's December 24th through January 4th that you will receive this shirt if you present to donate.
Yeah, and Lincoln, the information was on the screen. Thanks for bringing these shirts in, because you'll get one of these as well.
Absolutely.
Katie, have a great holiday.
Thank you.
Happy holidays
to you. Much success with the blood drive.
Thank you.
All